Howdy, everybody. Howdy, howdy. Okay, this was a request. I've had this request a whole bunch of times. And the request is, how do you figure out where to put a floating bridge once it's been moved and you don't know where it's supposed to go anymore? Sort of like I'm going to do it right now. Okay, so still got to loosen the strings. Stand by, I'm going to pause for a second. Okay, so your floating bridge is off the guitar. Right? It's off the guitar. Now we can sort of see an outline or a remnant where it probably should be or was. You can guess that that's the right spot, but it isn't necessarily the proper way to make sure that it's in the right spot. So hang on here, and I'm going to pan out and change the camera and quit stuttering like a monkey in a cage and show you how this is done. Okay, so it has to do with the distance from the nut way down over here to the 12th fret, and the distance from the 12th fret to your floating bridge should be the same distance. That's the roughed in version, so we're going to do that right now. So I got this big long straight thing here, and it just happens to already have a mark on it because I've been there, done that. Get this stupid little thing off of there. So if we go right, I'm hoping this is all in the movie, and if it's not, well then I'll have to redo it. So we put that right up against the nut. I'm hoping you can see that down here, and I'm going to go right to the 12th fret and make a line. That line has to be the same distance for this to even be close to being intonated. So let me get this back under the strings and we'll get that lined up. So I got the strings sort of on there, making it easy for me to move this guy around when I need to. So now I'm going to take that little straight edge, put it at the 12th fret, right at the center of the fretboard, and move this guy till I get the center lined up with that little mark I made. So that should make it really close to being perfect. The next test is we're going to tune the guitar and use the intonation to decide exactly where that goes. Now if you've got a bridge that has saddles on it, what I suggest you do is put all the saddles in their center position so you've got room to go both directions, and do the same thing. Measure from the edge of the nut to the 12th fret, and then take that measurement and go and line it up with the very center of the bridge saddle in the middle of the bridge, and then we're going to tweak things either by moving this slightly or by moving those saddles. I don't have a bridge like that to demonstrate on today, but that's how you do it. So the next step is what I'm going to show you. So now I'm going to set the intonation by using the tuner over here, and we'll fret the 12th fret and we'll make sure that it's in tune with the open string here, and then I will do the other high E string. With any luck, because of the compensated arrangement on this floating bridge, all the other strings are going to line up as best they can. Keep in mind, perfect intonation is a fantasy on any guitar. It can be very, very close. It will never be perfect, and that'll have to do with the way you play more than anything. So that's that. So let's fidget around with this, and I'll just try and get the camera set up so that we can see what I'm doing. This guitar's in open D, so that's how I'm setting it up. If you can see the tuner, well, let's tweak that a little bit. Seems to be a little bit on the sharp side, which means the string is too short. So we're just going to gently slide this back. Keeping in mind, I don't have any... The other strings are slack, so it lets me move it. I'm only using these two strings to set this up. seems to be not bad. Still maybe a little sharp, but I might be pulling it sharp. Still. A little bit more. You can see this takes some time. I like that much better. Now, with any luck, the other E string, or D string in this case, seems to be flopping back and forth in the middle. I'm not going to fight with that. That's as good as it's going to get on this guy. You can fool around with angling it. That's okay too. If it sits on a bit of an angle to get it right, then you're rocking. I mean, I never play up on the 12th fret on this one anyway. I just play slide on it anyhow. And it is just for demonstration purposes. But that's how you line it up. You can use a tuner to intonate it. You use a ruler to measure it. And then hopefully after that, whenever you take it off, mark it with a piece of tape so that you know where it goes back on the guitar when you're finished. And that's Dave's lesson today in how to set the position of your floating bridge on your Archtop guitar. Cheers, folks.